The First Jili-Fengshan War was a 1922 conflict in the Republic of China's warlord era between the Jili and Fengshan cliques for control of Beijing. The war led to the defeat of the Fengshan clique and the fall of its leader, Zhang Zuolin, from the coalition Jili-Fengshan government in Beijing. Wu Pefu was credited as the strategist behind Jili's victory. Prelude. Having jointly seized Beijing in 1920, the Fengshan and Jili cliques controlled the nominal government of China. Tensions soon began building between the two cliques in their uneasy coalition government. In 1922, the Fengshan clique replaced Premier Qin Yunpeng with Liang Xu without getting the prior consent of their partner, the Jili clique. While the Jili clique had the backing of the British and Americans, the Fengshan leader was backed by Japan. The Japanese government had once supported their enemy, the Enwei clique, but had switched sides soon after the change of power. On December 25, 1921, a cabinet under Liang Xi's leadership was formed with strong support from Zhang Zuolin, whereupon the new cabinet immediately granted amnesty to six former cabinet members of the Enwei clique. The Jili clique strongly opposed the plan but were overruled. The conflict further intensified as the new cabinet refused to give some $3 million in military budgets previously promised to the Jili clique. As a result, Wu Pefu and other Jili clique members forced Liang Xi to resign on January 25, 1922. With the pro-Fengshan clique cabinet having collapsed only a month after its formation, Zhang Zuolin threatened to resolve the conflict by force. Troops were deployed on April 10, 1922, though Wu Pefu and his Jili clique did not formally denounce their opponent until April 25, 1922. Forces. Jili armies deployed around 100,000 troops, while the Fengshan army deployed some 120,000 troops. The Jili army's commander-in-chief in commander of the Western Front was Wu Pefu. The commander-in-chiefs of the Central Front and Eastern Fronts were Wang Chengbin and Zhang Gerong respectively. Zhang Fulai was the deputy commander-in-chief of the Eastern Front. Zhang Zuolin was commander-in-chief of the Fengshan Army and commander of the Eastern Front. His deputy commander-in-chief and deputy commander of the Eastern Front was Sun Lik and the commander of the Western Front was Zhang Jinghui. Under him were three echelons commanded by Bao Dashun, Zhang Zuliang and Li Jingle. Strategies. In a repeat of the earlier Jili-Enwei War, the Fengshan army was to attack the Jili army on two fronts, east and west. The general headquarters of the Fengshan army was at Junlangcheng, which was also the Fengshan army headquarters of the Eastern Front. Commander-in-chief of the Fengshan Army, Zhang Zuolin, personally led the Eastern Front and on April 29, 1922 he reached his general headquarters and immediately ordered the attack. Zhang Jinghui was named commander-in-chief of the Fengshan Western Front, which was divided into three echelons. The headquarters of Fengshan Army's Western Front was in Changshindian, and the Fengshan Army in the West was tasked to directly attack the Jili Army's headquarters in Baoding. The Jili Army was deployed across three fronts. Wu Pefu's force headed by the 3rd Division in the West was headquartered in the region of Glazed Glass River. Wang Chengbin's force was spearheaded by the 23rd Division at Guan. Zhang Girong's force, with the 26th Division, was stationed in the east at Great City, and later was reinforced by Zhang Fulai's 24th Division. Wu Pefu was the commander-in-chief of all of Jili forces. Western Front. Fengshan troops deployed on April 10, 1922. After the war broke on April 29, 1922, the Jili army on the Eastern Front was driven back to Renkiu and Hekien. Western Jili forces did not make any progress under the heavy shelling of Fengshan army. On April 30, 1922, Wu Pefu personally went to the front line to order heavy shelling of the Fengxian front, while his main force outflanked the Fengxian rear. As Zhili troops launched its surprise attack on May 4, 1922, the 16th Division of the Fengxian Army defected to Wu Pefu. The temporarily organized 1st Division of the Fengxian Army was forced into retreat from Fengtai, and the defense collapsed on the Western Front. It was only when the 1st Division of the Fengxian Army was deployed in a counterattack was the Zhili advance checked and Changxindian was retaken. This successful counteroffensive by the Fengxian clique was, however, short-lived. Wu Pefu changed tactics by faking a retreat, luring the advancing Fengxian army into an ambush. As the unsuspecting Fengxian troops advanced, they overstretched themselves. Seizing the opportunity, Zhili troops flanked the enemy and re-seized victory. This time the victory was complete, the remaining Fengxian troops of the Western Front was completely annihilated, with the Zhili army turning its attention eastward. Eastern Front. The Fengxian army on the Eastern Front was initially victorious, with the Zhili forces holding on in a desperate rearguard action. However, as news of their defeat in the west reached the first echelon of the Fengxian army, Brigade Commander Bao Dashan refused to continue to attack the enemy, and left his flank dangerously exposed. In danger of being cut off, Zhang Zuolin ordered a general retreat to avoid total annihilation. The Fengxian second echelon, under the command of his son, Zhang Zuliang, was the cream of the Fengxian army, and became the main target of the Zhili attack. Having achieved complete victory in the west, Wu Pefu redeployed his crack troops and personally directed their attack on Zhang Zuliang's unit. Although Zhang Zuliang successfully repulsed the enemy's attack with minor casualties, they were eventually forced to lead an organized retreat, abandoning ground. The third echelon of the Fengxian army on the Eastern Front was under the command of Li Jingle, and initially succeeded in beating back attacks at Yaroma Crossing, though capturing over 1,000 enemy troops. Reports of the Western defeat saw morale collapse. Taking advantage of the situation, Zhili forces renewed attacks on the third echelon headquarters in Horse Factory, succeeding in killing and capturing over 7,000 Fengxian troops, and forcing the latter to give up Poplar Willow Green. Third echelon forces retreated to Northern Warehouse. While preparing to organize a defense at Junlangcheng, the Fengxian troops ran into nearly 20,000 Zhili reinforcements, which had arrived by train. The Fengxian troops were defeated, and the survivors were forced to withdraw to Luanzhou. By this time it was obvious the Fengxian clique was soundly defeated, and on May 5, 1922, the 23rd Division of the Zhili Army under the command of Wang Chengbin entered Tianjin. Fengxian forces suffered over 20,000 dead, 10,000 desertions and 40,000 troops surrendered or taken prisoner by the Zhili clique. Conclusion. By this time, British missionaries convinced the Zhili clique that the British consul at Luanzhou could broker a peace treaty to terminate hostilities. The British consul suggested a general outline to Zhang Zuolin, whereby he would withdraw all troops from the region inside Shanhai Guan and Zhili forces would cease giving chase. On June 18, 1922, representatives from both sides signed the peace treaty aboard a British warship anchored off the coast of Qingwangdao, agreeing the general guidelines suggested by the British consul. Shanhai Guan subsequently became the border between the two cliques, ending the first Zhili-Fengxian war with a resounding Zhili victory. The Fengxian clique retreated back to Manchuria, while the Zhili armies led by Wu Pefu took control of the central government in Beijing. Wu's Zhili clique ruled the Beiyang government alone until the 1924 Beijing coup.